think I've noticed two things that suffered. I've been looking for two things that at least may have suffered in your priority list. Teachers' allowance and nurses' allowance. Did they suffer? You've cancelled them.
Well, no.
Training teachers' allowance.
They were replaced. I think that the issue of allowances has gone through. You know, some of the institutions have become tertiary institutions. Mm-hmm. And some tertiary students are taking loans, others are taking allowances. You have to rationalize. Just like the wage situation we're talking about. However, the transition period has just been announced to make sure that it is not hurting those who entered with the policy
review.
You know, partially, I think there's, you know, it was given, a committee was set up and they came up, you know, with explanations.
Let me go on with Philip. Versi says that, good evening. Please, I want to ask the minister, Honorable Seth Terkper, the following questions. One, why he and the NDC party being anti-teachers? Two, why the salary arrears of teachers are not being paid at once but in batches? Three, are they, he and his party, sure they will complete the payment of the salary arrears by October ending as promised? Did you promise that you do October ending?
I don't, for a particular batch, probably
will that promise be achieved?
Yes, if we promise that we will do something, we will do it, because then the batch would have been processed and the timing and programming would be.
There
we are not anti-teacher. We are not anti-teacher. I think, you know, a teacher who puts, and I presume it's a teacher,
yes,
would agree with me that he doesn't receive paper, you know, pay slips anymore. He would agree with me that, you know, if he...
But allowance
the
for the training teachers is gone, actually.
Why are we, you know, allowances are important. But I'm saying that let's look at the totality of what we are doing. And we are saying that we've done significant, you know, progress. And I've showed what we are going to be doing through the very things that we are doing that have worked. You know, to
Bernard,
be,
but whose fault is it?
Excuse me, the political question must be answered,
Honorable. Whose fault is it? Because the MPP say that during their time,
let's be solution
the lending rate. No, we can't be, because we're going to elect somebody on December 7th. One of them is good, the other one is bad.
No, but I'm illustrating, you know.
But as finance minister, you have to lay the blame. It's 3 months to the election, Honorable Seth Terkper. Your supporters want you to lay the blame.
What I'm doing on behalf of His Excellency the President, it's not to, we'll spend the whole time in blame game. I am projecting the policies
but
that
we
want.
We are going to vote. Why must we vote for President Mahama?
But the justification for voting is in what policies the government is putting in place.
How did we and get have, to where we are? Why are we looking bad? Why must you do so much work?
I think that has been.
Is it the MPP that causes them? We don't vote them in.
No, that has been explained over and over and over. What I need to project sitting here is what policy measures we presented to cabinet, what policy measures we are implementing. The question is, how do we reduce interest rate? And I was saying, one, government was part of the problem. Government should raise revenues, and government should live within its means. And like the household, government will reduce progressively the deficit. As you reduce the deficit, two things happen. Government is not in competition, you know, with the private sector. Mm-hmm. The banks, therefore, the loanable funds, more supply becomes available because government is exiting. Second thing that happens, because of the competition to now satisfy private sector, that is the fundamental thing that will reduce the interest rate.
Okay, let me come in.
And so these are the points.
You are a teacher of economics. All what you've told us now, level 200 people in economics are told the same thing.
That's why I use the household.
Yes, they all know that.
It's very
Where
practical.
We are now, we are 3 months into an election. It is President Mahama and Seth Terkper, Nana Akufo-Addo and Dr. Baomi Akotose. We have to elect one of these groups. And the question to you is, you have to tell us that we are better than the MPP because they did this and we have done this. This interest rate, the MPP are telling us that when they were in power, people were not borrowing at the rate they are borrowing now. The base rate was not 26%. It is 26% now. Is it because Seth Terkper is not doing that great?
I think the important thing is that Ghana's, you know, interest rate has always been high. What we are showing is a consistency in policy implementation to reduce, you know, the rate.
The
consistency is what matters. Mm-hmm. And the track record to show, you know, that we've been able to tackle problems such as, you know, dumsor.
Have we?
Of course, we have.
Does this mean there are lights off places, few places?
Well, we there will be, you know,
intermittent.
It's intermittent. Mm. And I don't think that you can compare that to the situation.
No, not at all. Far from that.
And
should we be congratulating your government for taking us out completely?
The government, no, the government, of course, the government deserves, you know, some credit.
Mm.
But the government is focused. Remember, our focus is not just solving it and folding our arms. It's investing. And we did invest through the PRG, you know,
what's
in
PRG?
Bringing partial risk, the guarantee which the World Bank gave, mm-hmm. in bringing 10 field on stream,
mm-hmm.
and in bringing, you know, Sankofa, which is the most important one. And mm-hmm. we would therefore bring the gas. And so the independent power producer programs, you know, so you must show a long-term, you know, plan for growing the economy. And that is what we are
going to. I'll come back to the politics. Let's go to Machi. It says, it feels great listening to technocrats like Seth Terkper. We need more of such brains who do not allow their political ambitions to dilute their technical abilities. Okay. But he will still have to answer political questions tonight. Is there you have to tell us why we have to vote for President Mahama. Is there a net exporter or importer of... Is Ghana a net exporter or importer of oil? That's a good question. Are we exporting more than we're importing? Which is more?
I think we definitely import.
We still import more than we export?
Yeah, we do import. We do
in
import
terms of quantity?
More. In terms of quantity. But when you talk about exports, you should also... You know, part of the exports accrue to, you know, the partners, and then a portion accrues.
No, totally. In the gross imports that we do, is it as a quantity? Is it still more than?
We still a net importer in terms of value.
Yeah, Ghana, I know. That's what you said, but I just want as a separate question.
Ghana is still a net importer. I think that we should tackle the issue. What the electorate wants to know
mm-hmm.
is what policies His Excellency the President has put in place. That makes it possible. For example, let me give you two examples.
Mm-hmm.
That makes it possible to reduce debt and yet embark on major infrastructure development. And in fact, it is a development of infrastructure that will create jobs. It's a development of infrastructure that will create access to markets. It's a development of infrastructure that would open up, you know, the economy. Whether you're talking about schools, you're talking about roads, you're talking about...
And that's what the government is doing.
That's what the government is
doing. I ask you in the end of this program to give us an outlook for 2018-2017 so that we can be clear
it's
in this matter.
It's robust and positive.
Well, but some tangibles, if you like. But Francis Nana Abedu says that, good evening, please ask the Honourable Minister when will arrears of teachers from 2012-2015 batches be paid? Too many questions on that. Okay, Medo Saib says, please, Minister, the newly trained teachers, that again. Okay, Gilbert says that, please find out from the Minister when are they going to recruit statistician for all the district assemblies.
Can I address
the question of teachers?
I'm saying to teachers,
mm-hmm.
I'm saying to nurses, and mm-hmm. I'm saying to doctors,
mm-hmm.
that the problem has been systemic. The problem does not lie with only the financial clearance. Because when you are recruited, the HR element will come in. It's like Metro TV.
Mm-hmm.
When you are recruited, your first point of call is your HR manager,
mm-hmm.
who will then pass on your paperwork or hopefully electronically to the accounts department.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
So the delay is not entirely one of financial clearance. What we have not been doing in the past is to link the HR, you know, with the financial clearance. And that is what we are doing now. And so we are saying we are moving to a system whereby when teachers are recruited, they will fill their form electronically, the same way you can communicate with your bank, or the same way they are able to check, you know, their salaries today, the same way we are able to prevent through the voucher, the what we call the EIP voucher system, bring down ghost names. We are saying we are working with Public Services Commission, with Ghana Education Service, which is part of the pilot that is ongoing now, to make sure that going forward, we'll have a permanent solution to this, which is that your application for employment, for promotion, for transfer, for study leave, you know, and for retirement will be done, you know, electronically, and things will be done real time. The proof is that we have been able to resolve, as I said, issues like pay slip and arrest electronically, and we are moving to do this. 55 forms have been identified.
Okay. Okay. I'll show this to you, but I won't ask it. You know, that's one. It says, ask him why. If you want it known, you can read it, but I don't think it's a necessary question. You can see it. I don't even know whether it's true. Have you seen it?
No.
No, this one.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Can you remember why his family lives outside Ghana? Does it have anything to do with the economy?
Yeah.
No, it has nothing to do with the economy.
Okay.
I think the answer is simple.
Okay.
When I was coming back to Ghana, my
So let me, the question again is, can you ask him why his family lives outside Ghana? Has it got to do with the economy? You were saying.
No, I lived outside the U.S. Even my first son started primary one, mm-hmm. you know, in the U.S. And by the time I was coming, he was going into college. So mm-hmm. it would be huge dislocation, you know, for him. You know, so the mom decided to stay so they can complete their education. They finished and they would, if I had visited.
I think that's fair. Is he also studying economics or accounting, your son?
No, he's not. He's
okay.
doing criminal justice.
Oh, he wants to be a lawyer. okay. Okay, that's interesting. Now, have you paid the Electoral Commission all the money they need for December 7th?
No, we have a timeline for paying.
Would you obey it?
Yes, we will.
So you are confident that all
Let
the money...
Let me tell you why. Mm-hmm. I told this story and I told it to some judges. In 2013, mm-hmm. in 2013, we were doing the sovereign bond.
Yeah.
You know, around about August.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody said we should call it off.
Why?
Why? Because remember the decision was
the
pending
court. Yeah,
in the courts.
Yeah, yeah.
But we expressed the belief that Ghanaians would prevail,
mm.
and we didn't call it off.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, we were on the roadshow, you know, when the decision was announced.
Mm-hmm.
And the best rate Ghana has ever had in a bond issue below 8% was 2013. And I always cite this to say that for me, elections are also an economic event.
Okay.
Because it gives clarity to the investors that here we were, a country, you know, that could take decisions, you know, in the courts. And it was quiet.
Mm-hmm.
The anxiety was so high,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
you know, just, and we persisted and we had faith.
What has that got to do with paying Electoral Commission for the election?
Because the success of the elections depends on the disbursements of, you know, funds,
yeah, okay.
so that they can be prepared. Mm. And that is how crucial it is.
Will President Mahama win?
Definitely.
Will he win a first round?
Definitely.
Why must we vote for him?
Because of what I've been... Because he has demonstrated that when faced with a problem, he can resolve it. And at the same time, he's demonstrated that whilst resolving the problem, he's looking ahead and he can plan. And therefore, by the time you do the turnaround, you can see clearly that the economy is going, you know, into a growth phase. And he's the guy, he's the president who, therefore, would consolidate. We have not spoken about certain things. For example, the Exim Bank. Which
yeah,
is inaugurated.
That's a good one, yes.
Which is
that's
going
a new
to
one.
Help. Yes, many countries.
Going to help the export. We don't have much time. So you've told us why President Mahama. Why shouldn't we vote for Nana Akufo-Addo? I know you don't like that question, but you would have to deal with it. Why should we not vote for Nana Akufo-Addo?
I have justified why there should be a vote for His Excellency the President.
Why should there be a vote against Nana Akufo-Addo or no vote for Nana Akufo-Addo? This is his third
there
time.
Will always
this
be,
is third time for trying to be president.
There will always be those who will vote for Nana Addo.
But if you are telling us,
we are
why
talking
shouldn't
about
we?
No, we're talking about those who will make a difference, and we are appealing to them. And I'm saying,
why
just
should
if
that
I,
group,
I am saying
that group
that,
why shouldn't they vote for Akufo-Addo?
I am saying,
why should they vote for President
no,
Mahama?
No, because I have just demonstrated that there are programs, and in fact, we are going to put this,
mm-hmm.
you know, turnaround story.
You already have the green book. There's another book here.
No, this is on the economy that shows. You know, the progress that has been made. And so they can use it to judge for themselves because we haven't had time,
yeah.
you know, to...
Well, we may have to do this again on...